Tenfold is finally behind us, ladies and gentlemen. A new era of BRW is about to crash down upon us. This is season 2. The voice of Bravissimo is back on commentary. Welcome to episode number 5 of BRW Warzone. And we are kicking things straight off with an instant frenzy match that is sure to get you off your feet.
Scheduled for one fall, introducing first, representing the IPC, Tom.
Tom Doyle, the brother of one half of the Warman Tag Team Champions, Tori Doyle, has expressed on numerous occasions how much of a anti-fan he is of VRW management, and once again he finds himself in the setting of a frenzy match. The man has been demanding opportunity after opportunity to get himself in a Warzone championship picture. Management has not been listening.
And his opponent from Manchester, England, Ryan Matthews.
Ryan Matthews, the British alpha of the Warzone, looking to make a bigger impact on 2022 than when he entered VRW last year in 2021, transitioning from a tag team competitor to a solo competitor. Ryan Matthews is looking to make sure that this transition into the new year is one that can be well respected amongst the VRW Riots. Joe Garcia, your modern day cosplay character here in the Warzone, all geared up looking to prepare himself for an absolute fight, and that is exactly what we are about to have on our hands, especially with the combustible element of Tom Doyle. His presence in the matchup already ensures that there are going to be fireworks shooting off all around the Warzone tonight. Garcia looking to make headlights for his first match of 2022.
From San Francisco, California, Duncan.
Not exactly your typical standout guy, Mike Duncan. If the man has a problem with anyone, he settles it in the ring. He's got a problem with three other participants in this frenzy match because they stand in the way of a winning streak that the man is trying to provide himself here in 2022. Mike Duncan, one of the hardest hitting amongst the VRW Riots, has yet to earn himself that big match, that big time money match, to showcase what he is truly capable of. But perhaps after overcoming the fray in this frenzy, maybe then the VRW management team will start making big moves for Mike Duncan. Ladies and gentlemen, welcome to episode number 5 of season 2 of the Warzone. This is the voice of commentary. I am Quantismo, ready to kick off the night with a 4-person frenzy match. Let's get things started. And again, you gotta wonder the kind of mindset Tom Doyle is in after participating in the Roulette Frenzy match last week. Had the opportunity to inflict serious damage to one third of VRW management, that being Donnie Danger, who also found himself in the match in the same rotation as Tom Doyle. Tom had opportunities to get his hands on him, but it wasn't he who eliminated Donnie Danger in the moment of the match. In fact, Tom Doyle was eliminated way before Donnie was able to be removed from the matchup itself. The winner of the Warriors Roulette Frenzy, Eli Robledo, will be in action later on tonight. But for now, let's focus on the Frenzy match that we have in store for you right here and now. Ryan Matthews trying to go for the German suplex on the outside, but Duncan was able to block and counter Joe Garcia, going back after Tom Doyle and going after with a striking approach here into a snap suplex on the outside. Padded flooring, but the impact is still there. These Warriors still feel the brute force of being thrown onto the ground by another person. And Doyle tried to take the head off of Garcia. Meanwhile, on the other side, your right-hand side of the screen, Ryan Matthews and Duncan still going blow for blow against each other here. And Duncan going face first to that turnbuckle post. And again by Matthews. Now Matthews and Doyle switching things up here. Matthews now on the assault of Joe Garcia here. Tom Doyle going after Mike Duncan. Tossing Duncan back inside the ring. Garcia with a big attack on Ryan Matthews here, tossing him back inside the ring. Doyle now off the whiplash neck breaker to the outside. Only way to win this match is by pinfall or submission here. Shoulder first into the bat, Mike. Ryan Matthews here. Matthews with a huge opportunity against Garcia. Toss him back over to the outside. Opportunity wasted. Matchup has it. And inside the ring from the top rope, blocked and moved out of the way. And chopping the legs from underneath of Garcia. Ryan Matthews now switching targets again to Mike Duncan. Hey, here comes the cross buster by Tom Doyle. And again, Matthews bashing Duncan's face against that turnbuckle post. Trying to give the man a concussion here. And a drive-by boot to the side ahead. Meanwhile, inside the ring, Joe Garcia stuck with Tom Doyle. Doyle now off the deadlift into a German suplex, folding Joe Garcia. And Duncan able to get some offense on the outside here. Garcia now has him all the way up. Dropping him down with the California pile driver into the cover. Shooters at Dale Garcia able to kick out at 2.5. As Duncan and Matthews scramble to get back inside the ring. One fall, two, a finish here. Ryan Matthews up on the shoulders of Mike Duncan here, dropping him down. Into a cover, and Duncan having his pin interrupted by Tom Doyle, not allowing himself to lose the matchup here tonight. Here, kick to the midsection. Has him up for a suplex and drives him into a sleeper. Sleeper hold applied. Mike Duncan on the verge of tapping at Garcia, able to break out the submission. Duncan out of the ring, and Ryan Matthews has locked himself in on the comeback tree. Boys in with a clothesline, dropping Tom Doyle. Turns his attention to Joe Garcia, dropping him down with a kick. And now Garcia on the assault of Ryan Matthews here, goes into the cover, hooks the leg, and a quick kick out by Matthews here. Duncan and Doyle getting back to their feet here, back inside the ring. Trying to take shot for shot at each other here, trying to go for another pile driver, perhaps. No, Mike Duncan now caught him with a forearm strike, kick to the midsection, countered, picked the legs from underneath. Tom Doyle showing some athleticism. So, picture perfect moonsault, and Doyle now from the top rope, crashing to the outside with an elbow. Mike Duncan taking a lot of assault here by the fray of this frenzy. Garcia and Doyle back inside the ring now with their eyes focused on Duncan here. Duncan trying to fight himself out of the situation. Al has Garcia up on his shoulder here. Mike Duncan pop up into an ace crusher. And now it's Doyle trying to steal the cover, but Duncan bringing up the pin. Duncan with a swift kick. Chopping from underneath of Tom Doyle, catching the kick. Joe Garcia locking in an E-bar. Kick to the midsection by Duncan. Crossing the legs over. This is how you do it, the crossbuster by Mike Duncan. And now Duncan goes into the cover. Hooks the leg. Shoulders and tail kick out by Tom Doyle. And Matthews now has his eyes set on Duncan and Doyle here. Mike Duncan looking for a two-piece into another crossbuster. But Matthews joining the fray here, not allowing the painful attempt by Duncan. Mitch Noga driver into the cover. Shoulders are down here and a kick out by Duncan. But from behind, Joe Garcia trying to get the attention of Ryan Matthews here. Has him up. Suplex into a neck breaker. But Garcia, with his eyes set on somebody here, has Doyle spiking him down head first into the mat. Into the cover now. Shoulders are down. Hook the leg and Duncan making the save. A great sequence. And once again, face first. Garcia again. Into the cover. Shoulders are down. Hook to the leg. Ryan Matthews now. What a back and forth sequence here to kick off the war zone. Showcasing some high caliber action from the Warriors here. Hitting gyms, if you would. Now Tom Doyle going back after Mike Duncan. Close eye over and out of the ring. Kick to the midsection. Tom Doyle, powerbomb ace crusher. And now going into the cover again. Doyle having his pin interrupted by Ryan Matthews. From behind now, trying to go for that German suplex. Doyle able to counter. Now from behind, got caught. Ryan Matthews snapshot DDT. Into the cover again. Hooks the leg. Shoulders are down. And there's another save by Garcia. But Garcia got caught. Now the assaulted brute force of Ryan Matthews from behind, looking for a vertigo. Cover again, and Matthews bringing up the pin again. And now Ryan Matthews off the flatline and transitions into the Koji clutch. Submission applied, trying to force Mike Duncan to tap out, but an elbow. A stiff elbow rocking Ryan Matthews, and now Mike Duncan is on the assault. This has been a very physical matchup, to say the least. Mike Duncan was trying to go for another crossbuster, and now find himself on the shoulders of Tom Doyle. Off the Death Valley driver, still has a hold of Mike Duncan. Looking for a toe-paced Death Valley driver. And Joe Garcia looking to steal the cover. Looking to steal the cover, Joe, come on, come on. And there's a save. Striking from behind. Joe Garcia has him up, driving him down with a sit-out powerbomb. Back and forth action. Constant flow and rhythm, but the match continues here. DDT by Garcia. And now putting distance between him and Tom Doyle, looking for the fairy tale. At its finest, Garcia into the cover. Mike Duncan breaking up the pin before it could go down. Now keeping Doyle away from Garcia, dragging him by here. Duncan using the middle ropes to try to get a cover on Doyle, but it doesn't work. And now Joe Garcia still on the assault of Tom Doyle with a submission, but a drop kick interrupting the phase. From behind, Chicory Buster. And again, driving ahead, face first into the mat. Tom Doyle is down. Into the cover, Ryan Matthews. Saving Doyle and driving the knee into the side of head. Back and forth competition here. Flying to the outside goes Matthews. leaving Garcia alone with Tom Doyle, tossing him over the top rope. Garcia down. Oh, great counter by Tom Doyle. Back inside the ring, kick to the midsection. Looking for another power bomb. Ace Crusher. Down goes Garcia, cover again by Tom Doyle, and there's a save. Tom Doyle has had to put up with a lot of interruptions, not just in his career, but in this match as well. Garcia's on the ride again with a crossbuster. Hook in the leg, shoulders are down, two, and the save. No one's in a save for the kick out. Regardless, the frenzy match continues. Duncan down with Tom Doyle in the corner. Back and forth as they go like a pendulum swing. And a clothesline dropping Doyle. Duncan down with his focus on Garcia. Wants to put this matchup away as soon as possible. Garcia once again. Up, down, into a powerbomb. Matthews with his eyes set on Tom Doyle. Flatliner, closing clutch, no! Didn't even have the time of day to keep it locked in. Brain busted by Garcia. But right there is Tom Doyle. Has him up. And he's going to drive him down with the California pile driver. The cover. Tom Doyle with a victory here tonight. Now Garcia kicked out. 2.99. That was a prime opportunity for Tom Doyle, and it just slipped his grasp. And now Garcia back on top of the action, only momentarily off the back body drop by Mike Duncan. And now Duncan again, kick to the midsection. Garcia about to go up for a crossbuster, but Ryan Matthews with the save. Into a fairy tale of Matthews, but Duncan trying to steal now, and a breakup. What the hell is happening here tonight? Double super kick! What is this match to kick off this episode of the Warzone? Garcia now trapped up against the ropes by Tom Doyle. The anger is starting to show. Look at this! Combination and a swift double kick by Matthews and Doyle, but from behind, Mike Duncan kicked to the midsection, no, great counter by Matthews, transitions into an figure four. Getting tugged right there, just resisted there, but throwing back, Tom Doyle, he goes outside to the ring, misses with the drop kick, got caught, flatliner, into the Koji clutch, locked in on Garcia with no choice but to tap out. Matthews with the win.
Ryan Matthews.
It appears that everyone is trying to level up in season 2 of the OW Warzone. Look at the sequences that we were gifted with here tonight in this singles match, the first match of the night. The back and forth that these four warriors partook here was incredible. It was insane. Spot for spot, blow for blow, everyone trying to ensure the end of the matchup here. Joe Garcia on numerous occasions driving people's head into the mat with that driver. And then followed up with another amazing sequence. Duncan trying to go for the crossbuster, only for Tom Doyle to not drop him with not one, but two Death Valley drivers. Tom Doyle was in no good mood here tonight. Even had Joe Garcia trying to take the victory away from Tom Doyle. Doyle was not having it there. Not in the slightest. But neither was Joe Garcia able to nail Tom Doyle with a powerbomb. And then came the end of the match when Tom Doyle was out of the equation. Duncan was down and out. One flatliner lock in with a submission, and just like that, it was over. Ryan Matthews, from tag team specialist to solo competitor, he is making waves in 2022. Well, ladies and gentlemen, Ryan Matthews isn't the only one looking to make a big name of himself here in VRW. Tonight, we have three brand new debuts, and one of them is Tony Lee Williams. The Grizzly Killer is here tonight in the Warzone, making his all-time debut. And for the first time in their careers, Nikita Zane, Gray Suzuki, Roxy Guns, and Sierra Presley, all four of these war mains in a tag team match to main event the Warzone here tonight. The following contest is scheduled for one fall. Introducing first, a coming into the ring by Zigzag, representing Funtime Chaos. Boom! It's always a party when Funtime Chaos enters the building. Boom Boom, in a very rare one-on-one matchup. This is going to be interesting.
And his opponent, from Sacramento, California,
Ladies and gentlemen, the Grizzly Killer, Tony Lee Williams, has arrived in the war zone. This man made his VRW debut at the Roulette Frenzy match last week. And boy, did this man make a serious impact. Not too many people could say that they had their debut match, not just at a pay-per-view, but against two former world champions. The Grizzly Killer was holding his own, and look at this, guys. Tony Lee Williams, on his first night in VRW, pins a former world champion and did just stop there despite not winning the matchup entirely. Tony in general, being able to ragdoll former world champions throughout this phase in a Roulette Frenzy match was just an unbelievable sight to witness. If this is the kind of moves that the Grizzly Killer is going to be making here in VRW, then there's got to be so much more that he can provide for us here. Well, now TL Dub has to deal with one half of Funtime Chaos in Boom Boom, a man who hardly shows himself in one-on-one competition, but is surely a powerhouse amongst powerhouses. And look at the powerhouse skills of TL Dub. The man is freakishly strong, deceivingly powerful, to say the least here. Boom Boom locking in an ankle lock now. And now gonna lay down and sit on it too. Tony trapped in the clutches of Boom Boom here tonight. Not exactly how he wanted to start his debut here in the war zone, fighting against a man behind a mask. But Tony back to a vertical base here, but now he's about to throw his. Oh, a big chop here, got caught. Oh, with an STL slam. Funtime Chaos is definitely an eccentric team. They are very strange, and that is the thing that they use to their advantages in their matches. How unpredictable they could be in a scenario like this. For Tony, however, it's his first night in the actual war zone here in VRW. He has no idea what to expect, especially from someone like Boom Boom. Big knee to the face here, and there's a clothesline dropping a big boy. To think that TL Dub is here in VRW and Zigzag making a whole lot of noise to the outside, distracting Tony. Got caught, however, with a pump handle into a backbreaker by Boom Boom. It's the punch and a clothesline dropping the Grizzly Killer. And now into the cover, hooks the leg, shoulders it down. Quick kick out for Tony. Now Boom Boom might have a small size disadvantage against Williams, but regardless, he's one of the strongest members on the Warriors roster here at VRW. And oh, into the drop toe hold. Is if it's not the strength that Boom Boom possesses, it's the smarts. Knows how to find himself out of any situation here. Got caught. And a takedown by Tony Lee Williams with authority. Now Tony trying to rip the mask off of Boom Boom right now. Bending his head and neck backwards, trying to rip it off. And Boom Boom having a pick the legs on it, ain't finding an escape. Now, ooh, the strikes here on display. Kick to the midsection. Did Zigzag just throw a chair in the ring here? Oh! I think Tony was trying to go for a spine buster, but Boom Boom made a counter into a DDT, and now it's on the offensive. There's definitely a chair inside the ring here. Bulldog by Boom Boom. Face first into the mat goes Tony Lee Williams, and Zigzag played around a bit too much with the referee right now. And Boom Boom is taking that time, being as vicious as he wants to right now, trying to show the new guy the ropes. bending the arm back, trying to hyperextend it, dropping the double knees on the lower back of Tony. Now Williams here. Oh! A big shot to the midsection here. Backbreaker by Boo Boo. Transitions into a Russian leg sweep. And the back of the head crashing into the mat for Tony Lee Williams. Now Boo Boo here. Oh! Trying to go for that backpack stunner, but Tony was able to counter here. Stiff shots now by Boom Boom. Tony up against the ropes. It's a striking game going on here with Boom Boom and Tony. Able to kick away from the control factor. Now Williams stomping away at the back of Boom Boom here. The fans not having too much liking to the Grizzly Killer in the war zone here tonight. Here, stiff forearm strike. And now Williams gonna turn Boom Boom around here. German suplex. And this is shades of what we saw from the Grizzly Killer last week. Dragon suplex. And now Street Jacket German suplex with a perfect bridge into the cover here. And zigzag. Whoa, whoa, whoa. Come on, Zigzag, you're playing way too much now. Giving Boom Boom the advantage he needed, yes, here. And the referee is so close to throwing Zigzag out of the matchup. But I don't even think any of that has affected the psyche of Tony Lee Williams blasting Boom Boom with a vicious takedown and now has him up on the shoulders here. Oh! Holy crap, what a backbreaker by Tony Lee Williams here into the cover, hooks the leg, shoulders are down, good night, Boom Boom! Despite the main distractions of Zigzag throughout this matchup here, Tony Lee Williams still made ways in this matchup here, taking you a look back at some of the action and tried to go for that spinebuster, but Boom Boom able to find that counter, and this is just some of the skill and technique that Tony Lee Williams brings to the table, chaining all of these suplexes, ragdolling his opponent all over the ring here into a perfect bridge. And even with this Zigzag getting involved in the matchup here, interrupting a pin, but that didn't stop the assault of Tony Lee Williams right where he wanted Boom Boom up on his shoulders. And then sit out backbreaker! Damn near breaking a man in half. That is scary strength for Tony Lee Williams. Welcome, officially welcome him to the war zone. Well, ladies and gentlemen, he ain't the only one with a debut here tonight. Coming up next, we got ourselves another instant debut. The sister of Yasmin Mendez, Valerie Mendez, to make her official Warzone debut. And let's not forget about our main event, ladies and gentlemen, for the first time ever, Graceful Carnage, Kickstar Incorporated, tag team main event. All four of these war mains for the first time together in the same ring. It's gonna be amazing to see later on tonight.
The following contest is scheduled for one fall. Introducing first,
Roxy Blackheart, a knockout-looking war mania here in VRW, making her first in-ring appearance in 2022, looking to knock down a brand new war mania down a few pegs before she gets ahead of herself, coming into the war zone. Ladies and gentlemen, feast your eyes on Valerie Mendez. She is the sister to a war mania amongst the roster, Yasmin Mendez, making her Warzone debut last week. She made her VRW in-ring debut, and what a night it was for Valerie Mendez. First taking place in one round of the Roulette Frenzy match inside the ring with Suki Suplex and Eva Sinai. Suplex is one half of the Warman Tag Team Champions, and Valerie was able to pin and eliminate her. Not just Suplex, she eliminated from the Roulette Frenzy. She even eliminated the Warman's Television Champion, Eva Sinai. If you think that was it for her, she went on to the finals of the Roulette Frenzy and eliminated the Queen of the Warzone, Sammy Stone herself. We thought that Jada Storm revolutionized what it takes to make a debut. Valerie Mendez is on a completely different level. And let's see if she can keep that up tonight here in her debut matchup in the Warzone at a Boston A Party already. A much taller, much stronger competitor than she is, Roxy Blackheart. Optimus athletic as well. Holy crap. Of that flying clothesline, Valerie Mendez now from behind trying to get some striking game in set for this matchup here against Roxy, and now being whipped into that turnbuckle. Like I said, power disadvantage already starting to show for Valerie Mendez, Yasmin's sister, and Roxy now. Great count out by Mendez into that flatliner. Valerie, like I said, made an incredible debut last week and wants to ensure that the name Mendez is spoken about throughout the year of 2022. And Roxy Blackheart, face first, body first, into the mat goes Valerie. Now into the cover, hooks the leg, shoulders are down, and a quick kick out by Valerie. Now Mendez trying to get back to her feet. Vertical base here off the Death Valley takedown slam. Great catch and counter by Roxy Blackheart. Now trying to choke out Valerie here. A whole handful in the mouth of Mendez here. Driving the knee into lower back here. And a spinning back kick by Mendez. Trying to gain some distance and ground here. Now Mendez off the flatliner. Koji clutch is applied here. Submission locked in. And then, oh! Short-lived moment for Valerie here. Roxy not even giving her the time of day in that submission hole here. Looking for a suplex. Great counter by Valerie. Now Mendez going straight in for the cover here. Hand in the face and a quick kick out again by Roxy Blackheart. Amber Young talked about how she wanted to elevate the Warman's roster, not just by the roster's definition, but wants to ensure that the Warman's within the roster are performing at the top of their game here. And what an acquisition it is for Valerie Mendez to now be a part of this roster. Off the scissor axe kick. And now looking to put Blackheart away. Flipping pile driver. A Canadian destroyer by by Valerie Mendez. And Roxy Blackheart not going to be put down just yet. Now, oh! Stiff elbow by Mendez here, looking for a moonsault, but crashing awkwardly, coming down. And now Roxy Blackheart, oh! Great scoop slam, power slam, kick out by Mendez. Roxy now back to her vertical base here, locking herself into the comeback train. Ducks it into the clothesline, into a tilt-a-whirl backbreaker. Roxy now trying to go for that inverted facebuster once again. Mendez able to counter, super kick once again. Looking for that scissor axe kick. And now to the cover again. Hooks delayed. Shoulders are down on Blackheart, able to kick out at 2.5. Back and forth action that takes place on a normal basis here in the war zone here. The war maidens looking to make headlights here. Now, oh, great counter kick to the back of the hamstring. Turns her around. Now Valerie Mendez rushing leg sweep. And now has another submission. Hold an octopus stretch. Submission applied here by Roxy. Able to break her arm free and he strikes to the face. Escaping disaster. Now once again whipping Valerie into the turnbuckle here. Mendez now able to counter. Back and forth like a pendulum swing here, shoving her away now. Got caught. Look at the power of Mendez off the Samoan drop. Valerie Mendez looking to make a big fight feel here tonight. Slamming Roxy face first into the mat here. Throwing a temper tantrum. What the hell is going on? Mendez now. Oh! Got caught with a deep arm drag here. Roxy Blackheart now with a grip of the nape of the neck. Gonna drag Valerie around the peg here. Now tossing her through the middle ropes. Mendez able to hold on. But help. Roxy. No. Roxy, no! A pile driver to the outside! What is wrong with you, Blackheart? Trying to end the girl's career on her first night in the war zone. Mendez now back inside the ring here. Now, oh, kick to the midsection. Don't know how much of the effect of that pile driver lasted on her. There you see the wear and tear. There it is. The wear and tear clearly shown on Valerie Mendez after that pile driver from off of the apron here. Locks it again. Another Canadian destroyer. Cover again by Valerie Mendez. Welcome to the war zone.
Here's your winner, Valerie Mendez.
Keeping that same energy that she came into the business with last week, Valerie Mendez with a big win here on her war zone debut. Look at the skills. Look at the tenacity of Valerie Mendez that we now have the privilege of being a part of here. That pile driver from the apron looked like a serious drop, but Mendez was able to bounce back for the second time. Canadian Destroyer to Roxy Blackheart. The Mendez name is looking to go under a overhaul. Well, ladies and gentlemen, one more debut is still upon us here tonight. It is the debut of Eli Robledo here in the war zone. The winner of the Warriors Roulette Frenzy match, Robledo, will be in action next here in the war zone.
Day Tag Team Match, scheduled for one fall, and here's his record. Accompanied to the ring by Benjamin Earl, and the BIW American Revolution Champion, Mason Rex, representing American Tag, Benjamin Sorg, and Derrick Troy.
Mason Rex has been holding it down as an American Revolution champion. Here tonight, he walks in tow with American Terror as a whole. Benjamin Sawyer, Darren Joy, Benjamin Earl watching from backstage here tonight. Looking to see his investment take things to the next level in their tag team resurrection towards their goal of becoming three-time Warzone Tag Team Champions. Another successful title defense underneath the belt of Mason Rex. Let's see if they can keep their momentum going.
Their opponents, from Rostown,
Eli Robledo is here in the war zone. A surprise entry in the Roulette Frenzy match for the Warriors. The man won his first phase matchup, overcoming the odds, and not only that, overcoming the challenges that would occur within the finals of the Roulette Frenzy match. Eli Robledo will be in the main event of the Ultimate Frenzy to challenge the Warzone champion, whoever that may be, and his tag team partners also have dreams and aspirations of going to the Ultimate Frenzy.
At a combined weight of 495 pounds, representing Insurgency,
it was definitely quite the week for the Riley family name. Trish Riley, who ended up defeating Jada Storm, the first ever Gift of Valor champion. Trish has dethroned such an incredible reign. 255 days gone, and now Trish is the new Gift of Valor champion. Ryan Riley bore witness to this event, this historic event, and now Insurgency, without the Gift of Valor championship, now push on up the ante to get closer and closer to their dreams of becoming Warzone Tag Team Champions, much to the dismay of American Terror. Big night for American Terror to push forward. Big night. This is the Warzone debut of Eli Robledo. And look at how he has to start things off up against the big man of American Terror, Benjamin Sawyer, already locking in a submission hold on Eli. Single leg Boston Crab, not going to let Eli live in the moment and here and now. Eli Robledo winning the inaugural Roulette Frenzy match, along with Rachel Ross, who won the War Maidens Roulette Frenzy match. We'll see her in action next week, but tonight Eli wants to make a statement in his debut in the war zone. Does it end either the clothesline by the big man Sawyer? American Terror, former two-time Warzone Tag Team Champions. This unit has been around for quite some time. Mason Rex, we could go on and on about how many championships this man has held over the course of 2 years. The things that this man has done, the accomplishments that this man has made. And now reigning as your American Revolution champion, there's one championship the man has yet to secure, that being the Soul Survivor Championship. Mason Rex, hopefully with dreams and aspirations of sealing the deal one day. But right now, he has to knock down the momentum of Eli Robledo, a man who's already got goals and plans to be in the Ultimate Frenzy. And now making the tag to Ryan Riley, former Warzone champion of his own right, tossed over and out of the ring. Macy Rex to Kalezi, here comes Royal Solomon to make the assist here, and Mason Rex launching him across the ground. Now trying to go back and forth, but Ryan Riley face first on the apron, and from behind, Royal Solomon with a toss. Tag team continuity at his finest here. Kick to the midsection by Mason Rex, got caught, however, drops him down. Now gonna lock in an ankle lock. I believe is locked in here. No, so does locked in referees cut at six. However, Mason Rex found an escape, tossing Riley back inside the ring. American Tear. Oh! Again, who's been around for quite some time. Jada Storm, who assembled Ryan Riley and Royal Solomon close to the end of 2022. Ooh. Launching him into the turnbuckle of the opposing team here. Ryan Riley trying to get some redemption after being pinned by the new guy last week in the Roulette Frenzy match. The Grizzly Killer, Tony Lee Williams, who made his Warzone debut earlier in the night. Ryan having to correct a couple of mistakes here. Some may say that Ryan Riley betrayed Insurgency, yet here he is tonight, still teaming with Royal Solomon. Many believe that Ryan did nothing wrong in that situation coming to the outside during the matchup between Jada Storm and Tris Riley. Man said he was going to be a spectator. He bore witness to the crowning of a brand new champion, tossing Mason Rex to the outside again. Ryan Riley, the focus of attention here right now. And Riley has Mason Rex up, dropping him with a powerbomb on the apron. And Mason Rex down. Off the kick to the midsection, the super kick. Strike it back and forth. Counter for counter on display here. The belly to belly by Riley. As the ref's count begins to climb higher and higher here. And now again on the apron. Count is at seven. Both of these two need to get back inside the ring. And they do. But Mason Rex able to make the tag to Darren Troy, the Superfist leader of American Terror, and a small package by Ryan Riley. Let's get this matchup out of the way here. And Troy able to kick out. And Ryan Riley gonna now make the tag to Royal Solomon, the legal man of the team here. And here comes Darren Troy. Got caught, however, up on the shoulders. Driving him down with a spine buster. Royal Solomon, who made the proper choice of teaming up with Ryan Riley. Things have been going smoothly in their tag team career in VRW. Boom. Off the Death Valley takedown by Darren Troy. And Solomon able to counter with his own. Now they're locking a Dragon Sleeper hold on Darren Troy. Trying to force the man to tap out, Troy able to drive the knees into the face of Royal Solomon. Kick to the misses, another great counter, drop to a hold into the middle rope. Now Solomon gonna keep the advantage here. Royal Solomon was off there praised by BB Cash backstage for being a better competitor than Ryan Riley here. Royal Solomon looking to reconcile and keep that momentum going in his favor for his own sake. However, Darren Troy now off the pump handle into a face buster. Crashing down into the mat. Now Darren Troy looking to put it into the matchup here and now. Feet planted in the mat looking for the Trojan horse. But Royal Solomon able to counter. And now Solomon trying to go. Oh! Tried to go for that pop-up bumper cut, but Darren Troy had it well scouted. Now playing a bunch of mind games at Ryan Riley, dead in his face here. Troy just keeping Solomon away from making a tag, and the tag was made to the big man, Benjamin Sawyer, instead. Things are not looking well for Royal Sona here off the next snap. My Benjamin Sawyer is now a matter of wearing down his opponent here. And oh, sit out Uranagi! And Benjamin Sawyer is now gonna make the call to the other two! This is classic American Terror with their triple power bomb to Royal Solomon! And now Sawyer with the cover, hooks the lane, shoulders are down, Ryan Riley making a save! But here comes Mason Rex, has it up on his shoulders and dropping him down on the top rope into a gut buster. And now Solomon with only Eli Robledo to make the tag to a big forearm strike, trying to make the tag, but Benjamin Sawyer keeping him from doing so. And now Solomon trapped in a camel clutch submission by Benjamin Sawyer. Eli with no choice with the look of the arm going down. Solomon, however, breaks the grip and picking the leg from underneath. The opportunity that Solomon needed here, trying to go for a super kick, but got caught in the clutches again. Trying to break free, trying to make a tag, up on the shoulders into a power slam. So close for making the tag was Royal Solomon, and now Benjamin Sawyer is going to keep this offense going his way. Driving the knee into the chest and sternum. And now gonna lock in a submission on Royal Solomon. Torture rack is applied by Royal Solomon. Able to fight it off. Able to break free from the grip. Now back down to earth. Kick to the midsection. Solomon trying to go for a suplex, but no. Great cover by Sawyer again. And now making the tag to Mason Rex. Pop up into a power slam! The cover by Mason Rex to put Solomon away, and Ryan again making a save! And now a Northern Lights suplex by Darren Troy, eliminating Riley as another factor. Solomon continues to press on and continues to fight. And he'll try to go. Look out, belly to belly! And now going over to Robledo! Solomon having second thoughts, however, on the matter here. Wants to get back in on the action. Might have made a mistake here. Sit out! Spine buster by Mason Rex! Solomon now with the opportunity, making the tag to Eli! And Robledo is now in the matchup again! Misses with the drop kick! Mason Rex now with a turnaround DDT! There goes the momentum of Eli Robledo here. Oh! Off the knee tripler there for a second here. Eli with an opportunity now. Shoulder tackle by Mason Rex. This back and forth continues here. Eli now trapped in the corner of American Terror. Now trash like, oh! Over the counter, however, Eli gonna send Mason into his own corner now. The pendulum swing continues to go back and forth here. We're playing quarter tag. It got caught with a leg lariat by Rex. A little bit of innovation there here. Off the deep bar drag. No, great counter. Drop toe hold by Eli Robledo. Eli now off the wrist lock here. Driving a bullet to the side of the head. Eli making Mason Rex eat defeat. Intercepted here. Eli Robledo with the victory.
Yeah, you're
Eli Robledo has just pinned the American Revolution champion. Are you kidding me? What a month so far for Eli Robledo, aligning himself with Insurgency was the good call on his behalf. American Terror may want to push themselves for another tag team championship run, but they keep having hurdles thrusted in their way. And here comes the closing moments of the matchup here. The secrets between Eli Robledo and the American Revolution champion Mason Rex. Eli making the best of his opportunity with the assist from Ryan Riley, keeping Benjamin from bringing up the pin. Eli Robledo, welcome to the Warzone. Big win for you and Insurgency here tonight.
The following contest is scheduled for one fall. Introducing first, from the Celestial Cosmos, Shooting Star Whitney.
Shooting Star Whitney, undoubtedly one of the greatest high flyers to ever grace a VRW ring. Looking to make a highlight reel performance here tonight against an outstanding challenger.
And her opponent from Dublin City, Ireland, she is the VRW Women's Gift of Valor Champion, Triss Riley.
Ladies and gentlemen, the second Gift of Valor champion in VRW history, Triss Riley, for the first time ever stepping through those ropes as a champion in VRW. What a night it was for Triss Riley last week at Tenfold, where she was able to topple one of her greatest adversaries, Jada Storm, one-on-one. Some may call it a controversial victory, but the fact remains, we have a new Gift of Valor champion. Her name, Triss Riley, and she is looking to ensure that the prestige of the Gift of Valor championship stays intact with her reign here at VRW. Matchup now underway against Shooting Star Whitney, and right out of the gate, Triss Riley blasted her with a boot, but oh, able to counter already is Whitney. Like I said, Whitney is a very high flyer here, and that may cost her. Trying to go for her Karana off the gate, and Triss Riley able to counter with authority here. Now going to tie down the legs. Indian deathlock submission applied. You can't fly if your legs don't work all too well here. And Whitney able to break free before any significant damage was done. And there's a super kick already. Our War Man's roster has always had fair game within its ranks here. Riley able to blast with a stiff forearm strike, now whipping Whitney into the corner here. Incoming double knees into the top turnbuckle counter. And a kick to the legs here, up on the shoulders. A Shooting Star Whitney draping her over the top rope. As competition continues to reveal itself within the rankings of VRW, we gotta remember that the War Mans have to push harder than most. Shooting Star Whitney with an opportunity to gain a victory over the brand new Gift of Valor champion here tonight. Here, tilt a whirl into a DDT. Big play, big moves, all tied for Whitney here. Keeping this offense against a fresh champion, and Triss Riley still on the high of her victory against Jada Storm. Shooting Star Whitney looking to exploit this phenomenon. Now keeping the champion grounded, trying to hyperextend the arms, weaken the strength of Triss Riley, but Trish able to fight through the pain, able to get back to a vertical base here, elbow to the midsection. Oh, misses with the leapfrog. I don't know what she was trying to go for there. Thrown over the top rope, hanging onto the ropes, and blasted off of the apron by Whitney. Now the fight taking place to the outside here. Shooting Star Whitney looking for a suplex, blocked and countered by Triss Riley. Excellent counter. Now going to break the referee's 10 count. Perhaps going to stand inside the ring and enjoy herself as the VRW rides, enjoying the ride as well. And Whitney with a neck breaker. That overzealous nature cannot cost Triss Riley any of a momentum shift. Whitney still on the offensive here. That time the Hurricanrana connected. But Riley with the back and forth continuing to go on and on here. Whitney now back inside the ring, needs to start using her speed to her advantage here. Oh! Double arm German suplex. And Whitney landing hard here, but still able to press on with the fight. European uppercut connected, now toss into the corner. This time again, the double knees missed. And a swinging neck breaker by Whitney. Whitney now gonna drag her away from the ropes here. Not sure what shooting star Whitney has in mind, but has a lot of distance between she and Trish Riley. Whitney now slingshot into a neck breaker. Now goes in for the cover. Hooks the leg. Shoulders are down. Whitney not able to get the pin. Wasn't exactly sure what Whitney was going for there, but regardless, it worked out in her favor. Still has the upper hand against the Get the Valor champion. And this is where Whitney wants to be. She wants to be at the top rope. She wants to crash down. She's in the splash zone. Whitney with the inverted 450 splash. The 054 cover. Shoulders down on the champion. And no. The shoulder able to come up 2.99. What a win that could have been for shooting star Whitney to pull one off of the champion here. Kick to the midsection. Spinning brain busted by the champ. And now this second win perhaps setting in for Trish Riley, trying to go for the high knee. Got caught from behind. Reverse DDT. Whitney is performing at a formidable rate here against the new Gift of Valor champion, Trish Riley. Again, keeping the champion grounded, hyper-extending those arms. And out off the nip-up now. Riley back to her feet. Got caught in the clutches once again. Going into the corner. Face first in the top turnbuckle. And Riley countered by Whitney once again. Tossing in her ropes. Incoming Trish Riley here. Got caught with a drop kick. And I am a man that loves watching a beautiful drop kick being executed in the horror zone. Now Whitney trying to get Riley back to a vertical base here. Got caught with a European uppercut off the cradle. Hammerlock into a suplex by Trish Riley. And now Trish, look at the performer at an excellent level here. Tried to go on the comeback train, but got countered by shooting star Whitney. And now Whitney tossing the champion through the middle ropes. More distance to see she and Trish here through the bottom rope with a baseball drop kick. And so far, Whitney has been giving Riley more of a fight than she can handle here. Now back inside the ring, Riley being a bit too much. Oh, again being dropped with a neck breaker. Riley played a bit too much with shooting star Whitney, someone who is hungry for the opportunity to perform at this kind of level against a champion. Shooting star Whitney now gonna put your ticket on the comeback train. Thrown into the corner here, through the middle ropes, face through the turnbuckle and a head kick. Whitney now back inside the ring, catching a kick from Trish Riley. Now throwing it to the ropes here. Got caught with an elbow. Counter once again, blasting a heavy shot. And now Whitney propping Riley from the top rope. A precarious situation here for both of these war maidens. Avalanche experience fly! Whitney now into the cover. Shoulders are down. Kick out by Riley at 2.5. Pulling out all the stops against her opponent. Whitney coming at all angles. Using the ropes, everything around the ring to her advantage. Wants to make Trish Riley work for her money here tonight. Got caught over. Deep on Gregory. Cut it by Whitney. Now the strikes on display from Riley here. Swift concession here. And just doing what Whitney does and only better. Back at a vertical base again. High knee by Trish Riley. Into the cover. Hooks the leg. Shoulders are down. Whitney able to kick out at 2.5. Now Riley trying to put an end to the matchup here, looking for the Riley bomb, but a great counter and a super kick moved out of the way by Riley. Quick strikes. And a roll! Modified version of the Russian leg sweep by Riley. Whitney. Now being tossed into the corner. Whitney trying to make the best example at the expense of the Get the Valor champion. Looking for a two-peat here. Up on the top rope again. Another Spanish fly for the top rope. But Whitney not going for the cover this time. Jawbreaker. Great counter by the champion. Has her up. Driving down with a Riley bomb. With the bridge. Cover. Shoulders are down. Trish Riley with the win.
Here is your winner,
Trish Riley.
First night in as champion. And she gets the dub she wanted. Take nothing away from Shooting Star Whitney. She took the champion to a new level here tonight with her level of competition. But not going for the cover might have cost Whitney the victory there. She tried to go for too much and got caught into a Riley bomb. Trish Riley with a big win here tonight. And it was only a matter of time until we heard the anthem of the first ever Gift of Valor champion. BB Cass, Jada Storm without the championship. It looks so wrong. And Surrogacy making a second appearance here tonight in the war zone. And you know Jada has some strong words for Trish Riley after losing the Gift of Valor championship. Fireworks are about to fly, ladies and gentlemen. Oh boy. Why are they even here? Ruby Rebel Tori Doyle suplex. The Undisputed Elite is here in the war zone. Looking to chime in on the conversation of the matter. Hold on a second! Rhodes and Riley Knight, Silent Knight is in the building! This is an incredible surprise here! The only sister tag team in the IW! What is going on here tonight? Are we supposed to have a main event here in a few moments? Pandemonium! CJ Stone! Selena Stone! And the television champion Eva Cyanide! All in tow! This situation is starting to get out of hand, and you know what? It makes sense! For Pandemonium, they thrive off of the chaos of the War Machine's division! Well, finally we get someone who's supposed to be out here tonight in this time slot! Nakia Sane! Great Suzuki, Graceful Carnage is here! Trying to bring some normality to this situation! Anarchy continues to rise up here in the Women's Tag Team Divisions! Kickstar Incorporated now entering the fray! All these tag teams in one place! What is happening? Roxy Guns could have made an even better point. We need to get through. This is their first time ever being in the main event of the War Zone. Graceful Carnage, Kickstar Incorporated. Let's get things down to business here at the back. Trying to go for a spear. Roxy able to leapfrog a kick to the midsection. Driving a knee into the head. This entire tag team division has been set on fire here, and it doesn't seem like it's gonna cool down any minute from now. Great Suzuki and Roxy Gunn starting off this main event matchup here tonight. And Great City, Roxy Gunn's into the corner, kick to the midsection, counter, drop to a hole, dropping her down, submission deployed. Knee bar by Roxy, trying to force Grace to tap out. Look at that, kicks here. Kickstar Incorporated being introduced with some kicks from one of the hardest hitting war maidens in Great Suzuki. And there's a drop kick to the ropes. Things have gotten so heated here tonight. One can only wonder what is going to come of all of this from basically every war maiden tag team coming out here and putting their voice out in the matter. Great Suzuki off the double knees now. Toss into the corner. Great counter by Roxy Guns. Turns her around here. Now we're going to play ourselves a little bit of court attack. Toss it in to Kickstar's corner. Trying to make the tag, but it's not going to work out here. Once again, back over to Graceful Carnes' corner here. Trying to make the tag, and she does. Little bit of assist is here, and a big bicycle kick delivered. Making the tag to Sierra Presley. Two French women is here off the knee. Wow. And a big bicycle kick again. And a knee trembling in the kissing. Sierra Presley now elevated for first DDT. Gotta say that since watching Sierra Presley team up with Roxy Guns, she has shown that she is the pure muscle of Kickstar Incorporated trying to make the tag again. Sierra not gonna let it happen. Quarter tag once again. Toss it in the other corner here. Sierra Presley now trying to make the tag. No. Counter again. Nikita throwing her into Graceful corner. And trying to make the tag again. Back and forth. Pendulum swing broken by Nikita Sane. Trying to go for the spine, but it's a great counter by Sierra Presley here. Sierra now off the clothesline. Nikita Sane, a former television champion in her own right. The first ever Women's Television Champion. Now with her feet planted in the ground. Trying to put this matchup away. Has Sierra Presley up on her shoulders here. Looking for the compass rose. And now the cover! The shoulders are down for Nikita Sane to put the match away! And the shoulder came up at two! Sane looking surprised. See how close that was to being the end of the night for Kickstar Incorporated, making a tag once again to Great Suzuki here. Combination! Clothesline spear! Now Great Suzuki got caught with a chain break and a huge lariat! Cover by Sierra Presley and a kick out by Suzuki. Oh, now being able to drive the knee into the back, move out of the way, and a spear! Another spear! Like I tell you, Grace Suzuki, one of the hardest hitting amongst the War Maidens. A hidden gem within this tag team division. Again, making another tag to Nikita Sane. Now gonna fear! With a knee, another knee this time, made a chin. Tag team wrestling at its finest here, courtesy of the War Maidens roster. And now Suzuki, having to watch Nikita being thrown into the corner here, moved out of the way, however. Sierra pressing, oh! Off the strict elbow, got caught once again. Nikita Sane gripping the nape of the neck from behind here. Bashing her face first in that top turnbuckle. And here comes Sierra Presley. There's been a serious attitude change for Kickstar Incorporated. Being more vicious, being more deviant. Wants to ensure that everyone is speaking the name of Kickstar Incorporated. A Graceful Carnes have been waiting for the tag team division to go up in flames here. This is what they wanted. They want tag team wrestling. They want this opportunity to be themselves, the badass Sky Pirate and the badass Japanese Brawler. Now driving the elbows into the midsection of Nikita Sane. Now being tossed aside into the corner once again. Flies in with a back elbow. Sierra Presley now off the ring pulls with a Tiger Feet kick. Now climbing all the way to the top rope. Looking to fly into the elbow to the lower back of Nikita Sane. Now making a tag to Roxy Guns. Frequent tags is all we've been seeing throughout the match starting. And Roxy off the springboard. Oh! Came down and landed. On the Nikita Sane, didn't get all the kick, but the still was effective. Now toss it in the corner, making the tag once again to Great Suzuki. Throws in the ropes, bear clothesline combination again. Graceful Carnage, not being so graceful with their execution, trying to inflict as much damage as possible to Roxy Guns. Double knees, meeting the hole. now. Oh! A great counter by Roxy Guns here off the European uppercut. Counter once again. Toss it in our ropes. Kick to the midsection. Another counter by Roxy Guns. And now Roxy going to toss Grace into the corner. Kickstart Incorporated making the tag to Sierra Presley. And oh, knee to the midsection. Knee to the skull. Little bit of payback from earlier. And now Presley turns her around here. Russian leg sweep into the submission. Octopus stretch. Submission applied. Trying to force Grace to tap out, but no. Got her arm free and driving some punches into the face of Sierra Presley. Now caught in the clutches. Toss in the corner. Face first into the turnbuckle. And Sierra now off the double underhook. Has her up here. Sierra Presley, corkscrew neckbreaker connects. A move that's one of so many matches in her career in the war zone, and a kick out by Grace Suzuki. And Roxy goes to intercept, tossing Nikita out of the equation here. Sierra Presley looking for a 2B here. Kick to the midsection. Got the underhook underway here. Grace able to counter. Great counter by Suzuki. And now, the kicks, oh! Another step kick, stomping down on the head and a kick to the back of Sierra Presley. Hard hits, you can see the viciousness now starting to come loose from Grace Suzuki. The elbows, the kicks, oh, big moves in our arsenal here. Trying to size herself up here, got caught, snapshot DDT! And Sierra Presley hyping herself up, trying to lock herself in on the comeback train. Ducks underneath and a super kick. Straight to the chin of Grace Suzuki. Grace Hammer off that deep arm drag encounter by Grace. Now gonna drag Sierra by the nape of the neck here. Proctor up against the ropes, draped on the top rope herself. Nikita trying to extend her hand out, trying to make the tag, turned her around. Sierra, once again, locking the same submission, trying to force her to tap out, making her look in the eyes of her tag team partner. But Suzuki, once again, finding an escape from the submission. And now Grace, shoving Sierra around here. Presley not having it, tossing in a corner, trying to go for that tiger feet kick again. Not gonna happen here, Grace. Playing around too much with Sierra Presley, making the tag to Roxy Guns now. Now gonna tie her up in Indian deathlock here from the top, for the middle of the rope here, stomping down on the left leg of Grace Suzuki, already damaged leg. And now locking in a figure for a neck lock, trying to force a submission, but no. Able to counter and break free in a high knee. Into the cover, hooks the leg, shoulders are down, and a kick out. DDT by Presley. And from behind, reverse Famouser. Now trying to go after that damage. Left leg. Grace Suzuki tried to go for a spear, but ran into a knee instead. And now, oh, great move. Classic move from Roxy Guns. Water wheel takedown, and now locking in another submission, a layout Cobra Clutch, trying to force Suzuki to tap. And again, Suzuki finds an escape from all the submission holds that have been locked in on her throughout the match. Shoved again, missed, blocked, countered, spiking it, knee to the elbow, and a running knee again. Nikita trying desperately to make the tag so that Grace Suzuki can save herself from the brunt of all this offense. But has yet to be granted that opportunity. From the top rope, a double stomp to Suzuki. Now looking to put it into the matchup here. Kick to the midsection, great counter, a high knee. Trying to go for it again here, spiking the elbow into the knee once again. Trapped in Kickstar's corner. Once again making the tag. And now cartwheel into a
Oh, modified version of the Shattered Memory made famous by Austin Storm. And again, submission applied to bow and arrow. Trying to get Grace to tap on so many moves and angles, him but able to escape again. And got caught with a drop kick to the bad knee again.
Grace Suzuki has been trapped in the clutches of KSI for so long here. And again, Sierra from the top rope, another footstool. This is the fierceness. This is the ferocity of Sierra and Roxy Guns. Tired of waiting for the opportunity, trying to get themselves a tag team championship opportunity. They're done waiting. They're gonna hurt everyone and everything in their path. Another submission. Grace screaming and writhing in pain right now. And Sierra instead decides to release the hold. Gonna make another tag to Roxy Guns. And goes in for the cover here to put Grace Suzuki away, and another kick out. The fight presses on, now going after the left arm, after the left leg has been so damaged throughout the matchup here, now going after the right leg. And now Suzuki, able to cover, that was her opportunity to make the tag, but Roxy able to snuff that away. High knee into a bulldog. Again trying to make the tag, but Roxy's stopping it. They have been working so much on the left leg of Grace Suzuki, and now exploiting the damage even further. Roxy Gunn not giving a damn about Grace Suzuki one bit. And that was Grace's opportunity to tag once again, now locking into figure four, driving the elbows, making Roxy lose some brain damage here. Now back to a vertical base here. Roxy Guns trying to the corner. This is the opportunity that she needed here. Roxy stopping the tag again. And now going to the other corner, so far away. High knee again. Another bulldog. At this point, Roxy Guns is playing the mind games, making Grace think she's so close to making a tag, only to take the moment away from her again, and now locking in another bow and arrow submission. Trying to force a tap out, and again, Grace able to find the escape. Toss it KSI's corner once more. No fear in the eyes of Roxy Guns. The death stare of Roxy. This is what you have to contend with in your tag team division. Now kick to the midsection, countered again, and once again going after the left leg, another knee bar. All the hurt, all the damage has been done throughout the match to Grace's left leg. Found an escape, however, up on the shoulders. Oh, high knee to the head, to the skull, able to run out of the lane, and a kick, the roundhouse. Suzuki with the cover to win the matchup for Shayna Nakita, and there's a save for Sierra Presley. Trying to go for the infinite suplex of Presley, able to counter. That was Grace's opportunity to get the hell out of Dodge, but now there's no one to tag. High double knees. Suzuki having to be a one war-minded army, able to use her right leg to the fullest of capability. Suzuki now dragging Roxy away from the ropes, trying to secure herself an opportunity to get the pinfall victory. Suzuki has been fighting the war, and again going after the left leg, picking it from behind. And a big forearm strike by Suzuki. And the strikes and the kicks continue to be on display.
And now it's Grace Suzuki with the submission, trying to pull back the skull of Roxy, able to break free. Nikita back on the apron. This is the opportunity to hurt Corona again. Gapping the distance from making the tag. Roxy Guns, the playmaker, is what you should be calling her right now. Once again, locking in. Cobra Clutch submission. Is Grace Suzuki gonna tap out here and now? No, the elbows! The elbows able to break the grip! Elbows in the face of Roxy! That was the opportunity! Is this the time? Is this the time? No! Again, Roxy Guns stopping the tag from happening! With the knee to the face again, Bulldog now having a counter! Great counter! Now making the tag! The tag to Nikita Sane! Nikita finally in the match! Back in the match! Double knees to Roxy! Finally a moment of rest for Grace Suzuki, the former television champion, at work! Playing around with the VRW Riots! And now trying to hype herself up to be in a comeback train! No! Great cut and a takedown! Roxy Gunn snuffing all the momentum, but look at the catch! Great catch by Grace Suzuki, slinging her on that top rope! Prime time opportunity for the KSA on the comeback train! And a Pele kick! Listen to the VRW Riots! Double A spine buster by Nikita Sane! Into the cover! Hooks the leg! Shoulders are down! Roxy with a kick out of two! And oh, well, what the hell is that? Trying to go for a spear, but got stepped on by Nikita! Everything changed with the Sky Pirate into the building, making the tag! Now looking for the Sky Fighter! The cover by Grace Suzuki! Cover! Shoulders are down! Roxy having a kick out of 2.5! What a freaking match that we are witnessing here! Suzuki back in the match. I'm not sure how smart this is! Now tossed back in the corner, KSI here. Off the high knee once again. For the side with the Bulldog attempt! Grace Suzuki has her open her shoulders again! But Roxy able to counter into a reverse DDT! Suzuki should have stayed out of the match for as long as she could! And now once again, stomping on that bad leg, going after all cylinders! Oh! All that momentum for Graceful Carnage taken away once again! And now making that tag once more to Sierra Presley. Looking to put the flames out of this matchup here. Strikes on display, kick to the midsection, looking for that corkscrew neck breaker once again. Grace Suzuki able to counter into her Corona. Suzuki with another opportunity to make the best moment of this match. Now gonna toss things aside, toss it in the corner. With Nikita Sane waiting, oh! The elbow, knocking Nikita Sane off the apron as well. It's Sierra Presley extinguishing the fire of Graceful Carnage. Gut-wrench powerbomb. And now again, wants to put it into the matchup here, got caught and countered. High knee, tried to go for a spear, but ran into a knee. Everything has been shut down for Graceful Carnage up to this point. Kick to the midsection. Once again, up on the shoulder. corkscrew neckbreaker by Sierra Presley into the cover. Shoulders are down, up to the leg, and the save by Nikita. Looking for a Spanish fly. Elbows to the side of the head from behind. Another elbow. Now fighting for control here. Draw kick to the leg.
What a tag team match we are witnessing here. Sierra keeping her eye on the prize here. Trying to go for a German suplex. A counter by Grace Suzuki. Trying to go for one for her own. And out from behind, turn back around, throw into the corner of KSI, and the elbow by Grace Suzuki. And now Grace launching Presley over the top rope. But stuck with Roxy Guns in your ear here. Got caught, snapshot DDT. And now the kicks back on display. No, there's a high knee. Now both Sierra and Grace ignoring the referee's 10 count. Just turn this even more brutal. Count is at 7 here. Don't let this matchup end on a 10 count loss or victory here. Back inside the ring. Here we go. And now Suzuki able to make the tag again. Here comes Nikita Sane on the spear. Spear to Sierra Presley. And a clothesline drop and Presley again. Presley up the close. Oh! What a lariat by Sierra Presley. The cover turns it down. What a main event win. Kickstar Incorporated. Shooting the tag team division to the freaking stratosphere. That was an incredible tag team main event for both ends. For Graceful Carnage, for Kickstar Incorporated. These two teams brought everything to the freaking table. This is one of the closing moments of the matchup here. Grace Suzuki, who was in a matchup for so long, taking the brutal assault of Corkscrew Neckbreaker. That ended up breaking everything down here. Grace O'Connor and Nikita Sane tried to fight off both Roxy Guns and Sierra Presley as much as she could, but to her dismay, the 2-on-1 advantage favored KSI, and this was the end of the matchup here. Grace Suzuki able to make the final tag she could. And look at the spear right off the bat by Nikita C here, bringing all the last to fire. But one last lariat put down the flames of Graceful Carnage, ladies and gentlemen. KSI looking to invigorate the tag team division even more.